أجمعين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. So last time we talk about, we're still in the early revelation, and last time we talk about سورة القلم because it has a lot of new also ideas and notions. We talk about Surah Al-Takwir and the Day of Judgment and how the early revelation describe the Day of Judgment in details. After that, the scholars said there's surahs like Surah Al-Layl, Surah Al-A'la, Surah Al-Fajr revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here is still talking about the Day of Judgment, but here's also something new also, which is become one of the main themes of the Quran. The difference between the one who accept the message and the one who reject the message. The difference between Iman and Kufr is one of the main themes in Quran. And when Allah talk about these themes, He always give a lot of examples. So in the comparison between Iman and Kufr, it's just like light and darkness. It's just like a person who are alive and person who are dead. Just like a person who can see and see everything clearly and a person who is blind. A person who can hear everything and a person who is deaf. That's a lot in Quran, become one of the main themes. And the point here is to appreciate the ni'mah of Iman. That if you have everything in worldly matters in this dunya, and you don't have Iman, you lost everything. Your heart is dead. That's how Quran describes. That's why in Surah Al-Layl, for example, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى, when the night cover everything, وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى, and when the day is very bright and you can see everything. Why night and day? Allah mentioned night a lot in Quran, but every time He described night in different way. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى, different. That's the uniqueness of Arabic language. يَغْشَى, it means cover everything, then it's so dark. وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى, it means everything is bright. Why he mentioned this? Because he will say after a while, إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. There's big difference between someone who live in a dark and someone who live in a bright day. Big difference. And he used here سَعْيَكُمْ, which will become also a Quranic word. Allah will repeat a lot in the Quran. In Arabic language they say سَعْي. سَعْي usually is when you run towards something. And usually in Arabic it's always connection with rizq. If you search for your rizq, then you have sa'i. But the original word is just to run. Like our mother Hajar, when she run between Safa and Marwa, that's sa'i. Why someone run? Because there is a purpose, there is a goal. He run towards something. He look for something. Everyone also in this dunya, he look for something. But some people, they look for the main goal, why they are here. What's the purpose of this life? And others, they look after their desires. Look after for this dunya, which when they die, everything will finish. So he say, إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. There's a big difference between the one who accept the message and one who reject. Difference number one in objectives. different in wishes, different in thinking, the way they think. When you think that this dunya is just temporary, everything will change. If Allah tests you to lose one of your beloved in this dunya, how you interpret that depends on how you look at the dunya. So if you are a true believer, then Allah is the one who gave me this beloved person, and He is the one who taked from me, and that's not the end of the story. I will meet all my beloved in Jannatul Firdaus. It means when you believe, everything will change. The way you look at the dunya is completely different. The way you look at your wealth, it's from Allah as a test. Then anyone who is in need, I'm ready. That's malullah. That's not mine. Allah gave it to me and said, give it to the needy people. When I lost money, Allah is the one who gave it to me. I will try my best. I'll make another. Look at the conception. Everything will change when you believe. Because the central idea here is Allah is the creator. And He sent the revelation. With that idea, everything will change. Everything will change. That's why we found that this year, some non-Muslims in Western country, when they saw what happened in Gaza and how these people, they are steadfast and they lost everything and they still praise their Lord, they start searching for Islam and Quran. What's this? How can a person, he lose everything in one moment and he still praise his Lord? That's the Iman. Just like light and darkness. Not only that, Allah said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى. Allah said, if you believe, then the conception of giving now will change. You will be always ready to give. Allah didn't say give money, it's just giving. It's just that philosophy of giving. Just you are ready. Give my money, give my time, give my soul, give my children, give everything in the sake of Allah. The concept of sacrifice, giving. Why he easy for the believer to give? Because that's not his. Allah is the one who give him, and he said give, so it's easy for us. أعطى واتقى. Be mindful. He always giving, and there is also borders, there is prohibitions that Allah set to see who fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He will never come across that. That's how the belief in Allah changed everything. أعطى واتقى. Then he said وصدق بالحسنى. Then he firmly believe in Akhira. Allah called Akhira Husna. Husna is mu'annath, it means is like the best. It means this world is not the best. He believes in the best life. Opposite, the one who reject this message. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى. Stingy. Giving is difficult for him. Why he give? Because he can't give. Again, it's about the belief. This is my money. I collected all my time. Why I should give it to someone else? This is my time. I want to spend it as I want. Fulfill his desires. I think that will change. So he can't give in the sake of his Lord. But he said, وَاسْتَغْنَى. In the believer he said, وَاتَّقَى. أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى. He was fear his Lord, so he stay away from anything haram. Here, in the one who reject, he said, استغنى. It means he feel that he doesn't need his Lord anymore. It's just how he think when he reject this message. Allah said in the surah from the earliest also, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَرْرَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. طَغَى, it means he go beyond the borders. Human being has a limit. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala set some prohibitions for that. If you go beyond that, that's طغيان. It's come from طَغَى الْمَاءُ. When the water is go beyond the limit, this is طغيان. Insan also, when he go beyond that limit, because he thought, I don't need my Lord. فَإِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَرْرَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. Who can tell me in which surah this ayah? إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَرْرَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. Surah Al-Alaq. It's after the first revelation. عَلَّمَ بِالْقَلَمِ عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى. It means one of the main reason for طغيان, knowledge. When a human being have a lot of knowledge, which Allah tabarak give them ability to gain that knowledge, they feel that they don't need the Lord. So that's why استغنى, بخل واستغنى. And when they feel that, they will go through the state of confusion. في أمر مريج, like Allah said in Surah Qaf. Every time they come up with an idea which is nonsense. Then Allah said in the both, the one who now giving and be mindful, Allah will make his path easy. Easy path. نُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى. Facilitate the yusra. Yusra is anything, is the ease. It means all his path. What does easy mean? It means there is no confusion. He can interpret everything and put it in its place. I lost my brother. Yes, Allah gave to me for a while and he took it again. I will meet him in the day of judgment. Everything in its place. He can understand this life very well because he answered the main questions. Who is my Lord? Where I am going? And what's the... So that's why. But the another one who reject, نُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. Usra is difficulty. He will live in difficulty because confusion. He will live, it seems, very nice life, luxury houses, nice cars, and he will end his time with suicide, his life. Some of them write a letter, I change, I try everything, so I want to try the death. Because there is no purpose in the life. So that's usra, difficulty is everything. So that's one of the main themes in Quran came earlier, is to appreciate that you are believer, that you are mu'min. Very simple idea, but it's a very big and huge concept that you have the answer for the main philosophical questions. Why I am here? Who created me? What's the purpose of this life? You have a revelation, can tell you everything you Allah needs from you. And that's it. You should appreciate that and always remind yourself of the examples. Again, light, darkness. Summun bukmun umi. What does sum mean? Deaf. They can't hear anything. Physically? No. Spiritually. You are here to hear the revelation and then you don't hear it and accept it, it means you are deaf. That's the Quranic word. Summun bukmun. Bukmun is man, he can't talk spiritually. عميون, he can't see spiritually. So may Allah تبارك وتعالى give us ability to appreciate this light that Allah gave us. Shall after salah we'll continue بإذن الله. So the news spread around the world. That's why Mecca is for purpose. Anything happen in Mecca, if the Hajj season come, news spread straight away. Okay, so in the early revelation now, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala sent إِذَا جَاءَ تَبَّتْ يَدَ أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ. This تَبَّتْ يَدَ أَبِي لَهَبٍ, it come when Rasulullah SAW announced publicly that he is a messenger. Now all the Meccan people, they know that Rasulullah SAW is the messenger. That's why now become a lot of now how they receive this revelation. All the surahs after that is to respond to this. For example, the Mecca, they will said, Allah gave us everything. We are the best among Arabia. Our city is the best. It means Allah loves us. فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَّمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا. That's misconception. Some people thought that if Allah give me a good life here, a good car, luxury house, good salary, that means Allah love me. Allah said, كَلَّا. He could love you, there is no connection between that you have a good life in worldly matters and love of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Why? Simply because this life is a test. Opposite also, if you have a hardship in this life, that's not a sign that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala doesn't like you. No, it's just a test. So that's another concept. Another surah also, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the revelation is now in the early period, revelation come surah after surah, surah after surah. Till a time come, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't receive anything. فَتْرَةٌ مِّنَ الْوَحِي. The wahi stopped for a while. So Rasulullah SAW has go through a very difficult situation. His uncle, the wife of his uncle, Umm Jamil, now take the opportunity. مَا أَرَى إِلَّا أَنَّ رَبَّكَ قَدْ قَلَاكَ. He thought that your Lord now hate you. You will never receive any revelations. That's also one of the ta'aleem that for a while, then the revelation came after a while with these two surahs of Rasulullah SAW. That we have in the Quran some surahs just connected to Rasulullah SAW so much. Surah Al-Duha, Alam Nashrah, Inna A'tainaka Al-Kawthar. These two, three surahs. Wal-Duha والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى. And he swore by the duha, the morning time, the morning when the sun just rise, that time. Then he said والليل إذا سجى, and when the early also. When the time of night, saja is very nice word. It's not like yaghsha, not like aghtasha. Saja, it means there's a calm, peace at night, stillness. That's saja. Ma wadda'aka rabbuk. In duha, it's a time where all the people go to the work, to the schools. Busy time. Al-layl idha saja, peace and calm. He mentioned these two things to tell his Prophet ﷺ that this life you'll go through these two times. Sometimes it will be very calm and peace. Sometimes it will be very busy, like the time of duha. Once you are in this dunya, you always will go through this. Sometimes like this, sometimes like this. But don't think ever that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is abandoned you. Never think about this. It's just, this is the nature of this ibtila in this dunya. مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى. So he never abandoned you, never hate you. And he didn't say hate you. Hate you in Arabic, قَلَاكَ. He didn't say قَلَاكَ, he said قَلَى. He never hate. Hate who? Even the word hate, he removed the pronoun here. He didn't say hate you. You see, if I say to you, I don't hate you, you realize something, but you don't love me so much. Why you say don't hate you? It's okay. He didn't say you hate you. No, he didn't hate. The concept hatred is will never come. You are the beloved person to your Lord. مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ. Yeah, go on.
Salaam alaikum, Sheikh. This car, there is a red Honda SV 590WM is blocking the way. Honda, red Honda.
Okay. That's always fairness. One sister, one brother. Good. That's good. وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى. There's two interpretations here. الآخرة could be the day of judgment, جنة. خير من الأولى, it means better than this dunya. But there's another interpretation. وللآخرة, it means your situation in the end will be better than your situation in the beginning. It means Mecca period is better than Medina period is better than Mecca period. Rasulullah in the end of his life, not like Rasulullah in the early revelation, situation completely changed. Exactly like would change with the time of duha, where the people are busy, and the time of layl where there is sukoon and peace. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Allah will give you so much till you will be pleased. You know, in Quran, Allah said that pleased is always that we do so much to Allah, then Allah will be pleased with us. But when he talk about his prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, say Allah will give you till you please, O prophet. That's how his status in his Lord. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطَى تَرْضَى. Then he mentions something profound. He remind him of his childhood and his adulthood before prophethood. That's happened with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, happened with Musa. When Musa came to his Lord the first time, he reminded him of short summary of his history since he born till he come to meet his Lord. The point here is, everything happened to you or me, there's a wisdom behind that. Either you know it now or you don't know it, there's always wisdom behind that. So look positively towards your history, your past. Don't think negatively. Try to derive lessons from the past positively to take it to your future. Allah said, أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى. Have he not seen you an orphan, sheltered you? وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى. And he found you unguided, misguided. You don't know where's. You know that what people of Mecca did is wrong absolutely. You went to the cave of Hira. You look at this universe. You have certainty that worshipping idols, absolutely nonsense. But where's the guidance? Then Allah guided you. وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى. He was poor, in need. He was needy, and then he brought everything for you. Why he mentioned this? Because this is a very important lesson for all of us. If you are one day down, very down, remind yourself that Allah Tabarakata in the past, He take care of you a lot. The one who took care of you in the past will take care of you now also. But when we are in the middle of the difficulties, Shaytan wants to make this the end of the world. I always said that when you are in the difficulties and tribulations, just like when Yusuf was in the well. Well is so dark, and the walls is around, surround him. Just not far from the well, there's a caravan came specifically for Yusuf. Every one of us inside the tribulation, just like in the well. There's a caravan for us. We just need to think positively. How? Remind yourself how many times you was in difficulty and Allah removed that difficulty. How many? The one who did that in the past, he will do it also now. Then he reminded him to be good at people. He was orphan, take care of orphan. He was poor, take care of poor people. He was misguided, then dedicate your time to guide people. When he said, when he was orphan, be good to orphan. You was poor, then be good to poor people. But when he come to the dalan fahada, he didn't say he was misguided, guide people. No, he said, وَمَا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. The ni'mah that Allah gave you of guidance, spread this ni'mah and talk a lot. It means appreciate it, ni'mah. That when you taste the sweetness of guidance, you just talk to express your emotions when Allah Ta'ala give you this guidance. So Allah Ta'ala gave him this surah, and that one of the beloved surahs to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Surah Al-Duha. It's also for every one of us, especially when you are in difficulty. When you are in difficulty, remember Surah Al-Duha. Allahu awwadaka al-jameela faqis ala ma qad mada. I wish you know Arabic. There's some poetry, it's just amazing. Allahu awwadaka al-jameela faqis ala ma qad mada. Doctor, yalla, ishrah. Who can translate this? My English is insufficient to translate this. Go on, Anas. Yalla, doctor, daf Allah. Bismillah. Allah awwadaka al-jameela.
Allah has always blessed you with so many bounties and blessings to the extent that as if it's a habit. Awwadaka means it's habitual. So Allah has blessed you and gave you bounties and mercies.
So that فقس على ما قد مضى.
Always when you are in difficulties and you're struggling, remember that.
Very good. So Allah will always give you bounties. He never stop that ni'mah. When you are in difficulty, why you are worried? The one who gave you in the past is always there. So that's one of the earliest surahs also. And that's also a concept of even Rasulullah SAW. He went through a lot of difficulties. Difficulties is not for you, because I will end with this inshallah. And then if there's any questions, the way you interpret difficulty is very important. Some Muslims, when they go through difficulties, why this happened to me? I pray to him. I fast to him. I went to Hajj to him. Why this happened to me? MashaAllah. He never recite Quran properly. Because Quran is very clear in this concept. We'll come to that. Another type of people, Muslims, when they happen, they thought also, if some difficulties happen to other Muslims, definitely they have a lot of sins. They commit major sins. Look how difficulties they go through. Who told you that all the difficulties out of sins? Then why the Rasulullah, the messengers of Allah, go to the difficulties? Because they have a lot of sins. The main purpose before sins or anything else of tribulation and tests, because you are on this earth. That's it. Either you are Muslim, non-Muslim, child, old man, woman, men. This earth is the place of test. So don't surprise. This is the place of the test. If you don't go through test, you have to ask. Because this is the place of the test. Number two, that type of people, I pray to my Lord, I do why he did that for me. That's called he believe with conditions. Oh my Lord, I'm gonna believe in you, but I have some conditions. And there's no conditions in Iman. You are slaves, servants, and he is the Lord. If you know him, you realize that whatever you do in this life is nothing to what he deserves. So tribulation, because we are on this earth, yes, we can say, oh, maybe I have to do more of good deeds because of this. That's good interpretation. But why there is test? Because you are in this earth. That's the main reason. Allah said, لَتُبْلَوُنَّ Allah, indeed, Allah will test you. You came here just for the test. The another ayah at early revelation will expand this concept, inshallah. So I want to end it here, that even Rasulullah went through hardship. Just a few examples. Allah gave him 7 children. Zainab, Ruqayya, Umm Kulthum, Fatima, Al-Qasim, Abdullah, Ibrahim. He took all of them in his life except Fatima. And he is the most beloved one to Allah. He loved his city, Mecca. He lived there for 53 years. Then he left his country forever. He just came for the conquered Mecca and Hajj, and that's it. His grave, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in different country, not in his country. So if they force you to leave your country, that's not new. Even your Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that happened to him. If you lost one child, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lost 6 children. He loved Khadija, his first wife, and he never get married while he married to Khadija. Stay with her for 25 years. And then she passed away. So if you live with a spouse for a long time and they passed away, that's not new. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam faced that also. He loved his wife Aisha radiallahu anha, and the slander come from the hypocrites. And the revelation stopped for 1 month. And people talk against his wife and he can do nothing. If they talk against you, that's not new. Even our mother Aisha, she faced that. And our beloved Prophet faced that. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loved his uncle Hamza. And then he saw Hamza in Uhud. He saw his buddy. And they just open his belly in a way which is, he saw that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you saw one of your beloved in any place, that happened to him, that happened to Hamza Sayyidu Shuhada. He is the most honest person in the world. And they always spread in Mecca, he's a liar. It's difficult. This is one of the most difficult. That you know that you are the most honest person, and everyone, children around Mecca, children in the Mecca, everyone in the road say, this is the liar, this is the liar. That's difficult. And they say he is Allah tabaraka taala says with full of wisdom, and they say he is mad, crazy, magician. So he goes through a lot. So if you go just to be a role model for us, wallahu alam wa sallallahu ala abdi rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If there's any questions, التسجيل إلى هنا. تفضل. Okay. That question could be a one lecture. Okay. I did a full course to answer this question in Al-Furqan Mosque with the youth. Okay. Okay, just in brief, we have to know that both orders is from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. That's number one. Number two, why in this order? Number one, to show that Quran is a unique book. Tawrat and Injil revealed to their prophets one time. Quran didn't reveal once. Gradually, in 23 years. Why gradually? This book is not a book that you read in one sitting from cover to cover. Don't treat Quran like this. Never. Those people who think Quran is like any book, other book, I read from cover to cover. Oh, I read all this 10 juz in one jalsa. Quran is not like this. Ibn Mas'ud, one day one man came and said, I read all this ajza in one sitting. He said, أهذن كهذي الشعر. You thought Quran like شعر, like poetry? قفوا عند عجائبه وحركوا به القلوب ولا يكن هم أحدكم آخر السورة. Quran is come for guidance. So take your time. So that gradually, وقرآنا فرقناه. It means we descended gradually. لتقرأه على الناس على مكث. That's why Sahaba, they take 10 ayat till they understand it fully. So that's one of the main reasons. Second is about the context of da'wah, is about the purpose of da'wah. The people of Mecca is now mushrikun, not the people of the book. The people of Medina are the people of the book. So we want to talk to these people first, which is majority of people nowadays. They are just, they don't believe in books. So they have a certain type of talking also. Then when you come to Medina, that's another audience. So different audience. Third also, or fourth, that it means there's a lot of rules, the law and rules in Quran will come in the end of revelation. For the purpose that the methodology of Quran is when all the problems, Quran want to teach us this methodology. If you see problems in your children, in the society, don't look at the symptoms. Drinking alcohol is just a big sin, but just a symptom. Go and worship idol, this is big, but a symptom. Symptom of what? Of ignorance of Allah. Ignorance of knowing Allah. These people doesn't know their Lord. If they know their Lord, all this problem will solve easily. So he focused first in Mecca period on building that, who is Allah and why you are here in this life, and the battle between truth and false, this main concepts. But prohibition drinking alcohol, wearing al-hijab for women, all this will come later. When your heart full of love of Allah, it's easy to say sami'na wa ata'na. That's another also concept also. Allahu alam.
Similar to that question, if the wahi came down in that order of the surah towards the end of the Quran first and then the ahkam, why is it with the order now we have Baqarah?
Okay, why this order? That order is the purpose of da'wah. So if you want some lessons, profound lessons, how to call people, the first order is very important. But the second order, which is the last order, that's more even important. Why Surah Al-Baqarah, Ali Imran, An-Nisa? Why the longest surah in the beginning and the shortest surah in the end? Why Juz Amma, which about the Day of Judgment, is in the end, not in the beginning? Because now Quran spread, Rasulullah ﷺ spread the message. So the religion of Islam is very famous now, since Rasulullah passed away. Anyone who look for the right religion, he will go through a journey. You go to Buddhism, he will go to Christianity, Judaism, and then he will come to Quran, Fatiha, Baqarah, Ali Imran, and Nisa al-Ma'id. We talk to the people of the book, and they illustrate that they are not what they say, not true. They change their books. If you listen to many people who convert to Islam, you'll understand this. That when they open, the first story is story of Adam, which removed all misconceptions, which Christianity said that Allah descended Isa because it. So in the beginning, oh, that's not true. That's number one. Number two, Baqarah, Ali Imran, An-Nisa is all talk about the main concept in Islam. You know, in As-Sab'u At-Tiwal, all the concept of Islam is there. After that, it's just to repeat the concept in different way. So he made long surahs because every single surah has one main concept. Elaborate that concept. For example, Surah Al-Baqarah, to elaborate the concept of Islam. What does I am Muslim mean? I am Muslim, it means submit to Allah. What does that mean? Don't be like the people of the cow. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ. Okay, what's that? That's not submission. That's a main concept. And under that main concept, sub-themes also. One of the themes of that now the message is spread, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala now want to talk to all humanity, regardless you are atheist, you are from the people of the book, you are this order from Al-Baqarah, that's his target. That's why the first call is Ya Ayyuhan Nas. The first story is the story of Adam. Last thing also, this book, this also about to the Ummah in general. That's why Baqarah and Ali Imran and this Sab'at Tawal talk to the Ummah, not to the individuals. Insan is in the end, the word insan, from about the half and then the end, the Makki surahs. But in the beginning is about the Ummah in general, the identity of the Ummah in As-Sab'at Tawal. So Quran talk to the Ummah in general from the beginning. That's why, in many reasons also. Okay, sisters, any questions? Okay. That's right. Also, yes, that's right. And to support that, when Allah, for example, said, do you know Arabic? Okay. When Allah said, نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Tell my servants that I am the most merciful and the most forgiving. وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابِ الشَّدِيدُ. And tell them that my punishment is so severe. In Arabic, if there's outside the Quran, you expect the statement to be like this. Tell my servants that I am the most merciful, the most forgiving. And tell them that I am the most, he will talk about himself, the one who punish. But he didn't talk about himself, he said about, and my punishment, not him, his punishment. Yes, but in mercy, he didn't say my mercy, no, I am the most merciful, if that makes sense. And there is a lot of places in Quran like this. Just to show this. This is Surah Al-Hijr. I don't know which ayah. Ah. Yes. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Nahna kunna hanakhtim bil banat. Tayyib. حسد، جلسي، جلسي، جلسي. Okay. It just Surah Yusuf is whole for that. It's good to reflect upon Surah Yusuf because the main theme here is this. Sometimes jealousy is from some people who are so close to you. It's a big theme, but I can tell also that you can do something to remove that hasad. Relatives, jealous of relatives, not like jealous of anyone else. Number one, the relatives, they know you very well. If you have wealth, they know it. If you have so that why the Islam said, if you want to give charity, your relative first. Because they know what you have. So then you can remove that jealous. For example, number two, we are live in this country. Some people, they always, when they go to restaurant, go to any, they take pictures straight away, send it to their relatives back home. Why do you do that? They are go through hardship. And every time we are in London, we are in, yes, they love you, but you have to understand the situation also. That's very important. The more you give by money, by good words, by support, the more you reduce that jealousy. That's what's brief, inshallah. Allahu a'lam wa sallallahu ala abdi rasul sayyidina. Okay, that's the last one. I have another lesson. Yes, sir. In heritage. Okay.
Do you just not keep them?
Yeah. That's right.
To pass that message that...
Yes, that's right. You can do that. It's all about the wisdom, the hikmah that sometimes giving, sometimes even stop that to send a message. Yes, that's out of the hikmah. Yes, Allah knows.